Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Lisa, also known as ladolcelisa, and today I'm going to be teaching you yet again another Learn Italian lesson, and this one was actually requested by one of my followers, so thank you for requesting this video. I wasn't sure if I would want to record this considering the times we're in. Currently, I'm filming in quarantine, meaning we cannot go out and travel. And now this was requested to do a video where it comes to cuisine and ordering off of a menu. So today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to order and understand an Italian menu. So I'll be teaching you guys words and pronunciation and basically everything that you'll see on an Italian menu when it comes to lunches and dinners in Italy. I hope you guys find this useful. If you do, please give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. And of course, subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one. So without further ado, let's learn an Italian menu, guys. It's about time. So I have my handy dandy note sheet here so I don't get lost. Sometimes I can go off on a tangent when it comes to explaining these things. So for ordering off of a lunch or a dinner menu, you should know that lunch is called pranzo. Pranzo is lunch. Dinner is cena. Dinner is cena. Pranzo, lunch, dinner, cena. Let's learn the types of restaurants. So these are usually restaurants open for lunch or dinner in Italy. The first restaurant I'll talk about is obvious. La pizzeria. La pizzeria, or a pizzeria in Italian, is of course a restaurant that you will be getting a pizza from. Now this restaurant usually specializes in pizza, but of course they will usually have extra things. So a pizzeria is usually famous for just having maybe a small wine list and a beer list and an extensive pizza menu. You know a pizzeria is good in Italy if it is a wood-fired pizza oven. So basically anything that is fired up by wood. The Italian pizza is cooked much differently than it is anywhere else in the world. It's usually cooked at about 800 to 900 degrees, making it extremely hot. So when you order a pizza, it can literally be ready in like a minute and 30 seconds. So yes, pizzeria. Next is a trattoria, or la trattoria. Now this restaurant is usually a more family style restaurant. So it will be a lot more casual and homey, I guess, and a lot less expensive. So these restaurants are usually inexpensive. Trattoria offering usually more local cuisine, and they're usually delicious trattoria. So that's very recommended if you're on a budget. Next is similar, but they're different. It would be l'osteria or a osteria. So a l'osteria is very similar to a trattoria, except they offer a more simple menu. So again, simple dishes. However, they also offer a wine list, a more extensive wine list than let's say a trattoria. So unlike la pizzeria, la trattoria, or l'osteria, il ristorante is definitely much more expensive. It's much more elegant. There's usually a larger dining area, and it would be more recommended to go to this place for a more fancy dinner, you can say. So a restaurant would be your more expensive option, and they would of course have a more extensive drinks list, wine list, cocktails, what have you. Now, all of these restaurants will usually have a similar menu. Of course, a pizzeria will be a little bit more simple, usually probably specializing in pizza and then a couple extra dishes. But for a proper Italian menu, there are going to be quite a lot of things to go through. So I'm going to be teaching you all about them, how to pronounce them, and usually what you can expect when you're ordering off of this specific section of a menu and when. I should mention a few things. One, Italians like to take a nice lunch hour, so sometimes between, I would say, 3 to 5, the restaurants will usually be closed. So a lot of Italian restaurants are closed. They're not usually open between lunch and dinner. So you'll have a separate hour for lunch and dinner. Of course, if you're a real Italian local, you will dine later. So the tourists usually dine at around 6 o'clock p.m., whereas an Italian will dine at around 9 o'clock p.m. So that's just the difference when it comes to dinner. Now, on il menu, or the menu, first and foremost, the drinks list. So what you'll usually see is the drink menu, and they are called bevande. Bevande are drinks. That just means any drink from your waters or your soft drinks to cocktails and wine, etc. Now I'll just mention something briefly because I'm not going to go so into each section. I'm just going to briefly talk about it. But when it comes to ordering water in Italy, you can order water naturale or water liscia, your natural spring water. They call it liscia or naturale. So for natural water, it is liscia or naturale. Now, for a gassy water, they are going to call it con gas, but usually it's always called frizzante. L'acqua frizzante is gassy water, l'acqua naturale is natural water, and if you want the water from the tap, it's rubinetto, tap water. So tap water is l'acqua di rubinetto, tap water. But usually it would always come as either naturale or frizzante. Now that is for bevande, so di bevande. It is custom to order a drink first, even in Italy, so of course take a look at that first and order your drinks as well. Water, soft drinks, wines. So you can order wine, which is vino, vino rosso, or vino bianco. There's usually a list between the two. Rosso is red, bianco is white. Next, for the appetizers, they are usually called l'antipasto or antipasti. Antipasti is the plural, l'antipasto is the appetizer. So you would usually have an appetizer before a meal. Of course, on occasion, if you're going to have something simple, you can just add it and tell them to bring it at the same time. But of course, an appetizer is before the meal, that's what whets your appetite. So you would order l'antipasto or antipasti appetizers. This would usually be a selection of cheeses or cured meats or things like that. It of course depends on the type of restaurant that you're going to. Usually a pizza restaurant would have something like zucchini or arancini, which are rice balls. It really just depends on the type of restaurant you're going to and therefore the type of appetizers you would get. Next, il primo or primi, the first course. The first dishes that you'd usually order at a restaurant in Italian are pastas. And when you see them as di primi, they are usually less expensive, but that also means that the portions are smaller. To dine on a budget, you can simply order your pasta as your main dish. They'll be smaller and less expensive, but that is a good thing to do. In Italy, pasta is never eaten on the side with other things. You have pasta in a plate, plain, eat that, and then you're on to the next course or you're on to dessert, but pasta is just in a league of its own, so that would just be dedicated an entire first course just to pasta. So again, smaller, less expensive, and just delicious. That's my favorite course in Italy. Pasta, I primi. And if you watch my travel videos in Italy, you'll see that most of the time I would get pasta, especially when it comes to Roman pasta dishes. You can have carbonara, matriciana, cacio e pepe, so many delicious pastas in Rome. If you guys want a video on how to pronounce certain types of pasta dishes or certain dishes, that can also be a part two to this video. This one, I'm just gonna try to focus on the menu and not get so into the types of food. So after il primo or I primi, it comes il secondo or secondi. This is basically the main course or really the second course, but this is usually consisting of something more hearty, so it would be a little bit more expensive, but this would usually be like your meats or your fishes, or nowadays Italy's becoming a lot more vegetarian or vegan friendly, so this would be a vegetable-based option, but it would be more expensive and larger and more hearty. So il secondo is usually where you go when you're hungry and you don't just want a pasta. So a lot of the time, if you're going to be ordering something off of il secondo, you could even get a pasta as your antipasto or il primo. So instead of having an appetizer, you can get your pasta first and then you can get maybe a meat or a fish dish or a vegetable dish after that. So il primo and il secondo, the first and second courses. First, pastas, second, meats, but like I said, feel free to order a pasta as your main meal. It's very common. Now, what you'll find in il secondo as opposed to primo, which is pastas, you will be finding things like chicken, which is pollo. So in Italian, chicken is pollo. Next, steak is bistecca, or meat is carne. So bistecca for steak, carne for meat. Lastly, if you see this and it says frutti di mare, of course it could be a little bit more extensive, but this is just a basic list. Frutti di mare is basically mixed shellfish or a seafood sort of dish. So frutti di mare is basically the fruit of the sea, the literal translation, and that of course always means a mixed shellfish or seafood type offering. So you'd see mussels, clams, things like that. So for il secondo, you would see the types of meats, and you might also see the preparation. So I'll quickly just go over that. If you see anything that says forno, this would mean that it's baked. So al forno is baked in the oven. Fritto is fried. So you can see gamberi fritti, that would just be fried shrimp, for example. So anything fritto is fried and is usually good. Also, if you wanna be a little bit more clean and fresh, you would get alla griglia. Alla griglia is grilled. So anything alla griglia is a grilled, grilled meat, grilled fish, grilled chicken, what have you. So again, in il secondo, you can have your types of food and you can also see the preparation. So I hope that that was clear for you guys. On the menu, you may also see something called piatti tipici. That basically means traditional dishes from the region. So that would vary from region to region. Piatti tipici in Florence is a bistecca alla fiorentina. In Milano, it's a cotoletta milanese. In Rome, you'd see carbonara, or you'd see alla gricia, or you'd see something very specific. So piatti tipici is just the typical dishes, and you could even request what those would be if you want guidance in what to order, because usually by region, it's good to eat the typical dishes. Also, when it comes to Italy, usually il secondo, the second dish, which is specializing in something hearty and larger, it occasionally, not always, it would usually indicate, but occasionally this is not served with anything on the side unless it is stated. So you would have to order on the side il contorno or i contorni. So il contorno or contorni is basically a side dish, which is usually a vegetable in this case, or a salad. Now for my favorite part, i dolci, or il dolce, dessert. Of course, I am very familiar with that. My name is ladolcelisa, not because I'm sweet, guys, but because I like dessert. But really, this is my favorite part of the menu, and sometimes by the time you end up here, you're too full, and it's quite common in Italy for, you know, after lunch or a dinner, instead of getting a dessert, if you just go to a gelateria and get a nice gelato, a delicious ice cream. So I'll oftentimes do that. But if I'm at a special restaurant and there's something that I'm craving, like maybe a tiramisu or a panna cotta, you would order from this menu, the dessert menu, dolci. It's always written. And if you're at a restaurant, they'll usually have a special dolce della casa or torta della nonna. You'll see that very common. That just means the house dessert, or like the specialty grandmother's cake, torta della nonna. You'll oftentimes see that on a menu as well. Italian desserts are delicious. They can be heavy, like a nice heavy tiramisu or a panna cotta. They're full of cream. This contradicts another part that I'm going to be talking to you about in a second, but keep that in mind. You can get a delicious Italian dessert as well. So dolci, dessert. Now, usually on an Italian menu, especially a nice restaurant menu, you'll often see digestivi or il digestivo. This is literally a digestive, so usually an alcoholic digestive little shot. This aids in digestion, and oftentimes you'll see it in the form of like a grappa, a limoncello, or an amaro, which is a bitter. Amaro literally means bitter. So you'll, if you're in the Amalfi Coast, oftentimes they'll even bring you for free. It's not necessarily, but sometimes they'll offer you for free a little digestivo, which is a nice shot of limoncello, for example. So that's also there, and a lot of Italians like to have a little shot of liqueur to help them digest after the meal. Next, if you prefer to go more on the coffee route, you will see caffè. Caffè is coffee. Now, there's one important rule that I'll be talking to you guys about in a second, but usually a coffee, just a typical espresso, is just called normale, or just un caffè. So when you would order an espresso, just say un caffè per favore, un caffè normale, if you want to be specific, because a lot of times tourists like a nice long coffee. Italians don't really do the American style coffees. A lot of places are doing that as well now to accommodate the tourists, but mostly after a meal you'll just have a little shot of espresso and you're good to go. Now, this is what I have to say, which contradicts the dessert point, and that is about cappuccino. You'll never ever see an Italian ordering a cappuccino with lunch, after lunch, or for dinner. You'll never see that happening, because in Italy you don't drink a cappuccino after 11 or 11:30 a.m. So because a cappuccino has a lot of milk in it, they think that it would hurt your digestion, which doesn't make sense if you're having a nice tiramisu or a nice panna cotta. I think that's a lot heavier than a cappuccino. So that's something that I'm a little bit iffy about, but it's just the golden rule in Italy. You never order a cappuccino after your meal, or even with your meal if it's heavy. You only have a cappuccino for breakfast or in the early morning. So get your cappuccinos in before noon, guys, because after that, they'll know you're a tourist. So I hope this video gave you a better understanding on how to read and understand an Italian menu. It can be overwhelming with all the sections. I tried to go over things a little bit like pollo, bistecca, things like that, but I can get very specific and I can teach you how to pronounce certain dishes as well. If you guys, like I said, would like to see a part two where I talk about specific food or maybe specifically how to order off of a menu, what you can say or how to make reservations, please let me know in the comments down below because that really guides me in knowing what kind of videos you want to see, especially when it comes to this Learn Italian series. If you're still watching in quarantine, I hope that you have enough time to learn Italian. If you do, I know this video will come in handy for when we can travel again, because right now it looks like we can't, which is so tragic. But keep this in mind and maybe stay positive and optimistic. And if you teach yourself enough Italian, maybe one day we'll all be able to get there together. So guys, thank you so much for watching and I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye guys, or should I say ciao? Arrivederci. Ciao.